Bonjour, it's 5 Minute Molière. Today I'd like to talk about Molière's 1665 play, Don Juan. You'll notice that he spelled Don unusually with the M, but it's pronounced the same. So this at least distinguishes Molière from all other Don Juans. It comes from the Latin dominus, or dominate, for master. The character of Don Juan goes back to Tirso de Molina, a Spanish playwright around 1616, who wrote a play called El Burlador de Sevilla, The Trickster of Seville, with the subtitle El Convidado de Piedra, the Stone Guest. And since then, there have been hundreds of plays about this archetypal seducer of women. The basic story created by Tirso de Molina and used by most other versions is first Don Juan's seduction of a young woman who's either in the convent or intending to go into the convent. And secondly, the invitation to dinner of the statue of a man Don Juan killed in a duel. Well, in the 50 years between Tirso de Molina's play and Molière's version, there were dozens of other plays about Don Juan, mostly French and Italian. In the theater that Molière shared with the Italian players, the Palais Royal Theater in Paris, the Italian players had a version of Don Juan that they did every year. It was very lucrative for them because it had plenty of spectacle. And they performed in Italian, but the poster was in French, and somehow the title got garbled. So instead of the Stone Guest, it became the Stone Banquet or the Stone Supper. Well, Molière, just when he decided to do a dramatization of Don Juan, kept that part of the title as his own subtitle just because he knew it sold tickets. Well, why did Molière choose to do a dramatization of a play that was already being done every year in Paris? There are two reasons. He needed something quickly because Tartuffe had been banned, and he had to have a new play in the current season to sustain them financially. The second reason was because Tartuffe had been banned, he wanted to show the church authorities that he was not against religion, not against the church. He was just exposing religious hypocrisy, false pretended piety or devotion. Well, and since he had to write in a hurry, Molière wrote this entirely in prose rather than taking the time to put it into verse. There are several ways in which Molière's version of Don Juan is different from any other ever written besides that M in his Don. Well, for one thing, this Don Juan is not a lustful force of nature like all of the ones that came before Molière's. And it's not a rebellion against heaven and even earthly authority like the romantic Don Juans of the 19th century. Actually, Molière started by mocking vices that he saw at court. He was at court and he observed libertine aristocrats, or free thinkers they were sometimes called, who were skeptical of everything, made a show of being devout, but there was one who even held an orgy on Good Friday. So this is what Molière was trying to expose as a vice. And he thought this would get him back in the good graces of the church authorities who had banned Tartuffe. Well, it didn't quite work that way. But anyway, what else is unusual about Molière's version of Don Juan? His Don Juan does not behave as a swashbuckling man of action. He is more, his action is in the way he uses language. He seduces women with words. He argues abstract concepts to twist his valet's beliefs. He negotiates with the poor man in the forest scene, trying to make him utter blasphemy. And then he has some self-analysis. And he even explains, he knows quite consciously that what he enjoys is the pursuit and the conquest, rather than the pleasure of actually having what he went after. And he hypocritically uses compliments, all of the niceties of aristocratic gallant speech, to avoid paying his creditor. And this is actually one of the funniest, most farcical scenes in the play. It's in Act 4, right before the action becomes really ominous. And then finally, there is the breathtaking hypocrisy that Don Juan expresses in Act 5 when he pretends to have repented and fakes a conversion to religious piety. I mean, the outrage. He justifies this to his valet Sgonarelle, saying, "Hypocrisy has become a fashionable vice, and all the fashionable vices can be passed off as virtues." The truth is that Don Juan is so cynical and disassociated from humanity that the only thing he can say he believes in is 2 and 2 makes 4, 4 and 4 make 8. One of the best things about this version of the Don Juan legend by Molière is the role Molière wrote for himself, the valet Sgonarelle. Sgonarelle is often called a Sancho Panza type, in that he is a foil to the title character. This actor, Daniel Serrano, was a Senegalese actor in France in the 1940s and early 50s, and he is one of many who did a famous interpretation of the Molière role, the valet Sgonarelle. Beginning with his opening monologue on the pleasures of tobacco, Sgonarelle is a great source of fun in the play. Now, with 6 different settings, in 5 acts, plus all these spectacular effects, Don Juan was expensive to produce, but it was the biggest box office production in the entire history of Molière's troupe. It saved his 1664-65 season financially. It got 15 performances, all selling very, very well. And then next season, it was not revived. In fact, it was never again seen on stage until the 19th century. And some say this is Molière's masterpiece. of course, others say it's The Misanthrope, and others say it's The Malade Imaginaire. And then, of course, there's Tartuffe. Well, that's a subject for another 5-minute Molière. Au revoir.